Hello everyone, in this video let us discuss about the electric potential due to charged spherical conductor. Consider a spherical shell. Here capital O is the center of the spherical shell, capital R is the radius of the spherical shell. Let small plus Q charge is uniformly distributed over the surface of the spherical shell. Here point capital P is the point where we are going to find out the electric potential due to given spherical shell. Consider small r is the distance between center of the spherical shell and the point capital P. To find the electric potential at point P, let us make a slice of the spherical shell into two slices, that is, one is AB slice and CD slice. This ABCD forms a ring, that is ABCD here is a forms ring. And let us consider theta is the angle between C, O and E, and consider d theta is the small angle between A, O and C. Let small x is the distance between capital C and capital P. So here capital O is the center of the spherical shell, capital R is the radius of the spherical shell, Q is the charge which is uniformly distributed over the surface of the spherical shell, the units of charge is coulomb, and capital P is the point where we have to find out the electric potential due to spherical shell. Small r is the distance between center O and the point P, and ABCD, it is a ring formed between two planes AB and CD, and theta is the angle between C, O and P, and theta is the angle between A, O and C, and small x is the distance between capital C and capital P. As we know that there are three types of charge densities. One is linear charge density, second one is surface charge density, and the third one is volume charge density. If you consider linear, that means one dimensional, we use linear charge density. It is denoted by lambda, and that is charge by length. The units for linear charge density, lambda is equal to coulomb by meter, and for surface charge density we use in two dimensional, it is denoted by sigma, that is charge per area. Now units of the surface charge density is equal to coulomb by meter square. If use three dimensional, then volume charge density will be considered, that is denoted by rho. So rho is equal to charge by volume. The units of volume charge density, rho is equal to coulomb by meter square. Here the charge is uniformly distributed over the surface of the spherical shell. So here we are considering two dimensional, that is surface charge density. So sigma is equal to total charge on the spherical shell divided by total surface area. So sigma is equal to total charge is Q. Total surface of the spherical shell is 4 pi capital R square. Here capital R is the radius of the spherical shell. Now units for the surface charge density is coulomb by meter square. Let dq is the small charge on this ring ABCD, and let dv be the electric potential due to ring ABCD at point capital P. Here every point of the narrow ring ABCD is at the same distance x from the point capital P. So the electric potential due to charge dq on the ring ABCD at point capital P is given by, so dv is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into dq by small x. Here x is the distance between C and P. Consider this is equation 1. Here epsilon naught is the permittivity of free space, it is a constant. The value of permittivity of free space epsilon naught is equal to 8.9 into 10 power minus 12 coulomb square divided by Newton into meter square. But charge on the ring ABCD, that is DQ, is equal to area of the ring into surface charge density. So DQ is equal to area of the ring into surface charge density is sigma. So give this equation 2. But the area of the ring ABCD is equal to circumference of the ring into thickness of the ring. Assume this is equation 3. From the diagram, that is triangle CO and E, sin theta is equal to CE by OC. Here OC is the radius of the spherical shell, that is capital R. So sin theta is equal to CE by capital R. Now the radius of the ring CE is equal to R into sin theta, but circumference of the ring is equal to 2 pi into radius of the ring. Here radius of the ring is capital R sin theta, so circumference of the ring is equal to 2 pi R into sin theta. Assume this is equation 4. From the diagram, that is triangle A, O and C, sin d theta is equal to AC by OA. Here OA is the radius of the spherical shell, that is capital R. If d theta is very small, then sin d theta is approximately equal to d theta, then d theta is equal to AC by R. Here AC is the thickness of the ring, so thickness of the ring AC is equal to R d theta. This is equation 5. Now substituting the equations 4 and 5 in equations 3, we will get the area of the ring ABCD is equal to 2 pi R sin theta into R d theta, that is equal to 2 pi R square sin theta d theta. This is equation 6. But from equations 2, the charge on the ring ABCD DQ is equal to 2 pi R square sin theta d theta into surface charge density, that is sigma. But sigma is equal to total charge by total area. So sigma is equal to Q by 4 pi epsilon 4 pi into capital R square. Then DQ is equal to 2 pi R square sin theta d theta into Q by 4 pi R square. Here 2 pi R square will get cancelled. Then DQ is equal to Q sin theta d theta divided by 2. Give this equation 7. But from equation 1, the potential due to a spherical ring ABCD at point P, which is a distance from the ring, so dV is equal to 4 pi 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught dQ by x. Substituting the value of dQ in this equation, we will get dV is equal to Q sin theta d theta divided by 8 pi epsilon naught into x. Give this equation 8. From the diagram, that is triangle C, O and P, x square is equal to capital R square plus small r square minus 2 capital R small r into cos theta. Differentiating this equation, we will get 2x into dx. Here capital R and small r are the constants. So on differentiating these two, we will get 0. So 0 plus 0 minus 2 capital R into small r. So differentiation of cos theta is minus sin theta d theta. So minus will get cancelled here. So 2x into dx is equal to 2 capital R into small r sin theta into d theta. So sin theta d theta is equal to x into dx divided by capital R into small r. Give this equation 9. From the equation 8, so dv is equal to q by 8 pi epsilon naught into x into the value of sin theta d theta is x dx divided by capital R into small r. So dv is equal to q dx divided by 8 pi epsilon naught into capital R into small r. Consider this is equation 10. Here assume there are three type of conditions. That means if the point P lies outside the spherical shell, assume that is case 1. The case 2 is when the point P lies on the surface of the spherical shell. The third case is when the point P lies inside the spherical shell. Now case 1 is when the point P lies outside the spherical shell. Then the potential due to whole spherical shell is given by capital V. Here capital V is the potential due to whole spherical shell at point P. So capital V is equal to integral dV. Here limits are when we move from capital P to towards the spherical shell, the first point touch here and the distance is, so x is equal to small r minus capital R. Here the this is first end of the spherical shell. Then we move straight in straight direction. The second end is at a distance r plus capital R. So the limits is x is equal to minus r to minus minus small r minus capital R to small r plus capital R. So capital V is equal to integral r minus r to r plus r into the dv value is q divided by 8 pi epsilon naught capital R into small r into dx. Here q and divide by 8 pi epsilon naught capital R and small r are total constant, so it will come outside. So V is equal to q by 8 pi epsilon naught capital R into small r integral r minus r to r plus r into dx. Here integral dx is x. So V is equal to 8 pi epsilon naught capital R into small r. So x from limits r minus r to r plus r. So V is equal to q by 8 pi epsilon naught r into small r. So r plus r minus r plus capital R. Here small r will get cancelled and we will get 2 capital R. So here 2 r also will get cancelled. So finally capital V is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into small q by small r. So this is the electric potential at point P, which is lies outside the spherical shell, and the distance between the center of the spherical shell and point P is smaller. So this is the first case. The second case is when the point P lies on the surface of the spherical shell. So in this case, small r is equal to radius of the spherical shell, that is capital R. On substituting small r is equal to capital R in the above equation, we will get potential V is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into q by capital R. This is the second condition. So case 3 is when the point P lies inside the spherical shell, then the potential at point P capital V is equal to integral capital R minus R to capital R plus R q by 8 pi epsilon naught R into small r into dx. So V is equal to q by 8 pi epsilon naught capital R into small r. This is constant. So integral capital R minus R to capital R plus R into dx. So differentiation integration of dx is x. So V is equal to 8 pi epsilon naught R into R. So x limits is capital R minus R to capital R plus R. So V is equal to q by 8 pi epsilon naught R into R. So capital R plus R minus capital R minus R. By simplifying this equation, we will find capital V is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into q by capital R. Here capital R is the radius of the spherical shell. So this is the case 3. So here I write three things here. First one is when the point P lies outside the spherical shell. In this case potential V is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into q by small r. The second case is when the point P lies on the surface of the spherical shell. In this case potential V is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by capital R. Third condition is the point P lies inside the spherical shell. In this condition, capital V is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into Q by capital R. Second condition, in second condition and third condition, the potential is same. That means inside the spherical shell, at every point, the potential is constant. So here, when we draw the graph between distance R to potential V, it will come like this. So first condition, point P lies inside the spherical shell. V is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by capital R. So at the center of the spherical shell, the potential is maximum, that is Q by 4 pi epsilon naught into capital R. When we move from center of the spherical shell to surface of the spherical shell, the potential is constant, that is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R square. So from center to surface of the spherical shell, potential remains constant. After that, when we move away from the spherical shell, the potential will get decrease. So V is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R square. So V is indirectly proportional to 1 by R square. So as we move away from the spherical shell, the potential will get decrease. So this is same condition right side and left side also, left side of the spherical shell also. So this is about the electric potential due to charged spherical shell. Thank you.